Things are starting to get pretty hairy now. We're finally starting to run into some enemies who pose a threat. Namely, shadows and sheet ghouls. Uh-oh. And I'm freaking... I don't know, it wouldn't let me cast spells for a second there. These guys have the ability to temporarily deplete your strength. Well, it still says 22, but it's in red, meaning that I could potentially have a strength penalty there. It's just temporary, though. It wears off after time. Usually right after you rest. My inventory is getting kind of full. A valiant warrior. I hope that I am as victorious as he. I don't have what goes there, I don't think. No. Whoa! See if I can turn these bastards. I don't know, but they hurt. Run away! Actually, I think that one of the rings I found might have been a ring of food, because my food meter really doesn't seem to be running out that much. I think it was called a ring of slow digestion in Rogue. If so, that's a great thing to have. It means I probably won't even need my create food and water spell. See if I have any other spells available to me on level 3. Oh, I don't even have them memorized. That's right. See, dispel magic. I don't know what that does. Remove paralysis. Remove curse. And none of this stuff really helps me that much. Protection from fire will probably be helpful later. Water breathing will be helpful later. But I don't even know what... I guess it's supposed to be negative plane protection. Like... You can go into the negative plane. I have no idea, really. I'm just going ahead and get create food and water. Why not? I wish I had a better healing spell. I have to go up a few more levels before I get heal critical, though. And as you can see, that spell filled me up. Even though I probably won't need it. An empty alcove. Another key. Oh yeah, I was going to see if these bracers did anything cool. Well, they're bracers of protection plus 2. When I wear them, my armor class is 0. The question is, do I want an armor class of 0 or a strength of 22? Decisions. I think I'll keep my good strength for now. Did I explain that in second edition D&D a low armor class is good? Those freaking practice videos I made confused me. I can't remember if the stuff I talked about in them... Well, I get it confused with what I talked about in my real videos. I wonder why that's called a sheet ghoul. Because he spits sheets of acid at you, maybe. It's another one of those shrines. Let's see. We need a pearl here, I suppose. Man, whatever that monster is, it sounds nasty. I don't want to mess with them. Did I just not see that stuff that was laying around? I guess I must not have. I wasn't paying close enough attention. And in this game, you have to pay attention. Ha! God, you suck! Are you sure you're not undead? I guess not. I could have sworn ghouls counted as undead. A moonstone? Why, that goes right here. Come on. Yeah, I'm pretty sure one of those rings is a ring of food, because my food meter isn't depleting at all. I could probably rest, and it would barely go down. It didn't go down at all. That's awesome. I love not having to worry about food. It's so liberating. Come on. The problem with this game is it gives me too much stuff and not enough good stuff. My inventory is just crowded with crap. Potions I'm not going to use. Let's see what that vermilion potion does. Oh, it was a potion of food, which just makes things much more better. More better. Listen to me. I sound like a freaking retard. Well, how does this door open? Must be one of those one-way doors. Or a door you can only unlock from one side. Another roguelike game that I used to play a lot is Fatal Labyrinth for the Genesis. And it's pretty similar to, you know, all the other roguelikes. It's turn-based. But, interestingly enough, in that game it's actually possible to die by eating too much. If you overeat, then you start walking around really slowly. And then if you overeat too much, you die. Alright, I'm already cleric level 6. Wow, that was fast. Do I have any new spells? I have another level 3 spell available, but no level 4 spells yet. God, I can't believe how quickly I went up to level 6. Uh-oh. Oh, I'm surrounded. Not good, not good, not good. Crap! Heal me! Thank God. That was close. That's probably the closest I've come to dying yet. If I didn't get lucky, they would have slaughtered me. A mace I don't need. Another amulet of imminent return. And an amber potion. Potion left a dry taste in my mouth. Whatever that means. But yeah, actually Fatal Labyrinth was my first experience with roguelike games. I played it years before I played... Well, I guess it wasn't that long before I played this. But I played it years before I played Rogue, NetHack, or any of those. Now I have some sort of status effect on me, because there's a red border around my portrait. Whatever that potion did... It's helpful. Now over here we have a gong, and we have a hammer, but unfortunately it's the wrong color. It doesn't make the gong ring. We need to find the purple one. And there's a ton of monsters in there, of course. Need our bone key. One of the problems with being a cleric is that you don't really get a whole lot in the way of offense. I don't know, maybe later I'll get spells like Harm and Cause Light Wounds. Well, I have Cause Light Wounds, but it's not really worth using. Anyway, I'm starting to run out of time, so let's... Oops. Wrong one. Let's save our game, and I will see you guys later.